I usually sort of stay away from the venue until right before playing. I just generally go a bit sort of, you know, I go into a sort of a little minute of isolation. I need to be somewhere quiet generally for like half an hour before. I can't really socialise. Some people are really good at just sort of being in the party and then going straight on. I need to kind of remove myself from it for like 20 minutes and then sort of, you know, then kind of reintroduce into the whole situation. DJing has always been more immediate. You know, with a live show, it's a rehearsed thing, whereas DJing is a lot freer. You can kind of sort of move in any direction with DJing. I'll be working on music, ready to play it out that night, you know. So like tonight, for example, there's stuff that I've never played out before, and it's just this sort of very spontaneous, it's a very spontaneous thing. The biggest joy I get is getting a reaction from something that people haven't heard before. There's obviously the big tunes that people know, but to get that same energy and that same enthusiasm out of music that our room of people have never heard before, that's the real joy with DJing. It's the set that I feel obliged to play, which is the one that represents my own music, and it's the set that I want to play, which is probably less of my own music. So I try to sort of get that balance where I'm sort of representing my own sound enough that the people who want to hear it are going to be happy. It's almost trying to sort of lead people in a place they didn't expect to go. We've done, you know, the big London shows before, like Alexandra Palace or Roundhouse, and we kind of program this whole day, but it was still under the banner of just like a Bonobo gig. So the idea of Outlier was a way of taking that idea and sort of expanding it into something sort of larger than myself. I'm working on the new record at the minute. I don't know where I am with it. I suspect about halfway, but I won't really know until it's finished. Yeah. The way I'm writing at the minute is a lot of contrast. It's hard to say how it's going to go really at this point, but I think that dynamically it's going to be a bigger kind of shift. You know, the quiet is going to be very quiet and the loud is going to be very loud.